Hello, my name is Daniel Nordhoff. I'm the product manager for Power Arrows working at Kvaerneland. Today, we want to talk about rigid Power Arrows. We offer a range of three different models. The low series is the M series, the medium series is the H series, and the big tough series is the S series. The M series Power Arrow range is offered in 2.5 and 3 meter working widths. Those machines are released for tractor sizes up to 140 horsepower. The H series Power Arrow is offered in 3 meter, 3.5 and 4 meter working widths and is released for tractor sizes up to 180 horsepower. The S series Power Arrow range is offered in 3, 3.5, 4 meter and 4.5 meter working widths and is released for tractor sizes up to 250 horsepower. We will start with the M series. On all Kvaerneland Power Arrows, doesn't matter if it's M, H or S series, we offer always 4 rotors per meter working widths. This ends up in 12 rotors on this example at 3 meter. Per rotor we offer 2 tines, and the tines do the work with the Power Arrow, so that's the most important part on our Power Arrows itself. This is an example of a Power Arrow tine. In this case, it's a tine from an M series Power Arrow. The thickness is 12 millimeter and the length is 280 millimeters. And you see in front, there's the knife which cuts the soil quite easily and is sizing down the clods in the field. The tine is bended 90 degrees and it's bolted, in this case with 2 bolts, on the M series. On the M series Power Arrow, we offer two different solutions. The first solution, this is the series solution, is the bolted version as it is shown here. You see there are 2 bolts which are connecting the tine with the tine carrier. The second solution is the option part, and this shows the quick fit system where the tine can be mounted without any tools. Just a bolt and a clip who is locking the bolt, and no spanner or something else is needed to change the tines. If you need to change your tines because they are worn out, take care that you use original Kvaerneland spare parts. You see it if you have a look on the Kvaerneland arrow printed or locked on the tine. Let's have a look on the quick fit tine change system. Therefore, we move to the H series Power Arrow. Here you see how the tines are mounted on the Power Arrow. It's just connected by one bolt, and this bolt is secured by a clip, and the tines can be changed easily without any tools. Here we do have two examples for the tines for the H series. The tine has a thickness of 15 millimeters and a length of 330 millimeters. We offer two solutions of tines. This is the passive tine, this is the active tine. The active tine is going in this angle into the ground, so we do have a positive angle. It's digging into the ground and doing a more aggressive work compared to the passive tine. Here we do have a negative angle. The passive tine is working better in stony conditions because this passive tine won't move up stones from the surface as much as an active tine would do. So you have to choose if you want to have a passive tine or an active tine. In addition, we offer both solutions with the carbide layer on the surface, which extends the lifetime a lot. On all Kvaerneland Power Arrows, we do have a Helikan tine positioning, meaning that the tines are not placed 90 degrees to each other, but in a line. This curved function with the tine positioning allows an easy flow in the soil and an aggressive work with the soil. This is the headstock for the Kvaerneland rigid Power Arrow range. You see the stiff and robust design. This is the lower linkage. In this case, it's mounted at category 3. We are able to change this from category 3 to category 2 while changing the brackets. They're going to the inner side, then you are at Cat 2. In addition, you can switch between category 3 bolts or category 2 bolts. We offer both solutions, and all bolts the lower one and the upper one are protected against rotating with this protection on this side. All three-point linkages can be adjusted with a hydro linkage to couple, for example, a maize planter or another kind of seed drill behind the power harrow. Or you can display here a triangle to hook on famous seeders like an DA or an S-drill. The side plates on the power harrow take care that the soil will stay in the power harrow and you will have no ridge or something else at the end of the working widths. The unique version on the side shields at Kvernland is that they are hooked parallel. So if they have to move up because of a stone or an obstacle, they move up in this direction. And they will not walk sidewise and extend the working widths. So the aim is that the clots will stay in the machine. To achieve this, there is a spring-loaded protection, which ensures that the things are staying in the machine. Now the machine is above 3 meter transport width. If you want to drive on the road, you just have to take away the bolt and leave the plate down, and then you are below 3 meter working width. Now you can drive securely on European roads. Another working tool in the power harrow is the leveling bar. The leveling bar is placed behind the rotors and in front of the packer roller. The leveling bar has the function to stop big clots before they want to leave the power harrow. And the rotors can cut them down to small sizes. We can adjust the leveling bar toolless with a crank. Take away the clip and just turn it up or down, whatever you want to need to reach a level ground before the packer roller is consolidating the soil. All leveling bars are equipped with a spring-loaded overload protection to avoid that big stones will hit or touch the machine or destroy it. On the Kvernland power harrows, we offer two different solutions for the depth adjustment. On this model, we see the single adjustment. There's a single beam which connects the packer roller with the trough of the power harrow. On the other model, we will see later the Euro connection. The adjustment is quite simple. We have 18 different holes. This allows the customer to reach the right working depths. And when you want to adjust the working depths, you just have to take this bolt and put it in another direction. This is a square tube bolt, which avoids wear within the bolt. In addition, you can adjust the lower position of the packer roller. This screw here, there are three different positions where you can change the roller depths when you lift up the machine and you will reach additional lifting height with the roller on the headland. This is the second solution we offer for power harrows to adjust the working depths. This is the called Euro connection. You see here, this is a parallelogram linkage and there's a hook where the coulter bar for the E-drill, C-drill or for the DF1 front hopper combination coulter bar could be mounted. The principle for the depth adjustment is similar. You have again the square tube bolt secured by a clip. This can be adjusted in 18 different depths. And in addition, you find the lower depth adjustment when you lift up the power harrow on the headland. You can adjust the depth, how much the packer roller is falling down. On the SCS power harrow, we do have the strongest trough. Our troughs are made with a sandwich concept, meaning we have two lines of steel placed here and the bearings of the rotor are placed on the lower and on the upper side. This is made to reach stiffness within the trough and to make the machine stable for a whole lifetime. Different soil conditions require different packers. At Kvernland, we offer a wide range of different packers, starting from a cage roller, taking a tooth packer, a cracker packer, or Arctipack packer. All packers are equipped with bearings which are maintenance free. You will find no grease nipple on the bearing side. The cage roller can be used for light soil conditions. The tooth packer can be used for light, medium and tough soil conditions. The cracker packer can be used in medium and heavy soil conditions. And the Actipak packer is well known to be used in medium and heavy soil conditions. The Actipak packer is equipped with an additional knife in between the lines which are cutting the soil a second time for a good and fine seed bed to be prepared. For more information, contact your local Kvernland representative or have a look on our website.
When farming means business.